Let's take a look at this chart. And let's assume that you're on a flight. You're starting at Claxton Evans County Airport in the lower left-hand corner of the chart down in Area 2. And you're going up to Hampton-Varnville Airport in the upper right-hand corner of the chart, which is in Area 1. And the question you're trying to answer is, what compass heading will you need to fly for that trip? Well, in addition to your departure and destination airports, you need some additional information. Part of what you need to know is the wind. So let's assume the wind on that trip will be from 280 degrees at 8 knots. You also need to know your true airspeed. So let's assume your true airspeed is 85 knots. Okay, the first thing you want to do is draw a course line between your two airports from Claxton Evans County Airport up to Hampton-Varnville Airport like we've done here. Once you have your course line drawn, estimate the direction you're going to be flying. As you can see here visually, you're going to be flying essentially northeast bound. What that will do is let you give a test of reasonableness to the number that you come up with in a little bit for your compass heading. If it's way off of northeast, you know that you've probably got a mistake in there somewhere. You also want to estimate the wind effect. You're flying northeast bound and you have a wind from the west 280 degrees at 8 knots. So you can visually see that you're going to have a little bit of help on the flight, a little bit of a tailwind effect. But you're also going to have a wind from the left side as you're flying northeast bound. That means you're going to have to crab a little bit to the left to compensate for it. You'll carry a little bit of a left wind correction angle. And again, estimating the wind effect lets you apply the test of reasonableness to answers that you come up with later on. Okay, what we need to do now is measure exactly what our true course is on that chart. So we need to find a line of either latitude or longitude that goes through our course line. Let's use a line of latitude. Let's use this one right here, and we'll use it where it intersects our course line. First, put the grommet in the center of the compass rose of the plotter on the intersection of that line of latitude and our course line. Next, make sure the 90 on the compass rose is lined up on the line of latitude. Then look around the compass rose to find our course line and read the degrees off the compass rose. Now we already know that we're going basically northeast bound, so we're looking for a true course that's got us flying in a northeasterly direction. So here's our course line. Here's 40 degrees, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, and our true course comes out to 045 degrees. Now let's go over to the wind side of our flight computer. And when you get to the wind side of your flight computer, what do you suppose the first thing you put on there is? The wind. So rotate that clear plastic disc until the wind direction of 280 degrees is underneath the true index up at the top. Now we want to mark the wind speed. The way we do that is, first of all, we find that center grommet in the center of the clear plastic disc. And then we move the inner slide up or down as we need to, so the grommet in the center of the clear plastic disc is sitting on 100. We're going to use the arc for 100 as our handy reference starting point. Now we're going to mark the wind speed up from that center grommet. We're going to mark it up 8 knots because that's the wind speed. So go up from 100 to 108 and put an X on there for the wind. And once you have an X on there for the wind, draw an arrow from there to the center grommet. And that will let us visualize the effect of the wind. Now what we want to do is put our true course under the index up at the top. And our true course, as you remember, we measured off the chart, and it's 045 degrees. So rotate that compass rose, that clear plastic disc, until 045 is underneath the true index up at the top. Now, once we have our true course under the true index at the top, what we want to do is go back to the X for our wind. And when we get to the X, we want to move the inner slide up or down as we need to, so that that X is sitting on the arc for our true airspeed. And our true airspeed was given as 85 knots. Here's the arc for 80, the arc for 90. This is the arc for 85 knots, and we make sure that the windex is sitting on it. Now, once you've done that, you can visually see a couple of things. First of all, here's the effect of the wind, and you can visually see, as we did on the chart, that we have a slight tailwind and that the wind correction angle is going to be to the left. Well, we can tell what our ground speed is because the ground speed is underneath the grommet here, and it's a little bit of a tailwind, so it looks like the ground speed here is about 89 knots. The wind correction angle, we can tell by how far to the left or to the right of our center line the X for the wind is. In this case, the X for the wind is to the left of our course. And the question is, how far to the left? Well, here's the line for a 5-degree wind correction angle. We're one line short of it, so it's 4 degrees of wind correction angle, and it's to the left. Now, are we going to add or subtract a wind correction angle to the left? We're going to subtract it. And one way to remember that is to look at the compass rose up at the top of our flight computer. If you start at the top with 45 degrees and you go to the left, notice that the numbers get smaller, 40, 35, 30, and so on. So a wind correction angle to the left will be subtracted. On the other hand, if you went to the right instead, you see that the numbers get bigger. So wind correction angles to the right are going to be added. Now let's move down to the bottom of the flight computer and fill out those boxes to find out what our compass heading is. We start with our true course, which we measured off the chart, and our true course was 045 degrees. Now we just calculated our wind correction angle as being 4 degrees left. So put a minus 4 degrees in the box for the wind correction angle. And then we subtract them. 45 minus 4 gives us a true heading of 41 degrees. What we've done here is to compensate for the effect of our wind, and our nose is 4 degrees more to the left than it would have been if we'd had no wind at all. Okay, we've got our true heading. To go from our true heading to our magnetic heading, what we have to do is know what the variation is, and we get that variation off our chart. So let's take a look at our chart, and what we're looking for is a dashed magenta line. Now, when we look around, the only one we can find is one running kind of diagonally in the lower left corner of the chart, just to the left of our departure airport. And that magenta line says on it that our variation is 6 degrees west. Now, do we add that or subtract it? We're going to add it because east is least, west is best. And when we take a look at the box at the bottom of our flight computer, it also says to add westerly variation. So put a plus 6 in the box for variation. True heading of 41 degrees plus 6 degrees variation gives us a magnetic heading of 47 degrees. Okay, to go from our magnetic heading to our compass heading, we have to know what the deviation is in our magnetic compass. Now, in real life, you would look at the compass correction card that's on the front of the magnetic compass in the airplane. But since you don't have an airplane in there at the test with you, what you have to do instead is to look at the figures. So take a look at the compass correction card in this figure. The top line of this gives you the course that you're trying to fly. The next line down tells you what you need to steer on your magnetic compass. For instance, if you were trying to fly a course of 030 degrees, you would steer on your magnetic compass 027 degrees. That's a correction of minus 3 degrees deviation. On the other hand, if you were trying to fly a course of 60 degrees, you would steer a course of 56 degrees, and that's a correction of minus 4 degrees deviation. We're trying to fly a course of 47 degrees, which is pretty much halfway between the 30 and the 60, maybe slightly more on the 60 side. So we need a correction that's about halfway between minus 3 and minus 4, or minus 3.5 degrees of deviation. In this case, let's use minus 4. So when we take a look back at the boxes on the bottom of our flight computer, for deviation, let's put a minus 4 in there. A magnetic heading of 47 degrees and a deviation of minus 4 degrees gives us a compass heading of 43 degrees. Let's summarize how we got there. We started off on the sectional chart, and using our plotter, we measured the true course as 45 degrees. Using the wind side of the flight computer, we calculated that the wind correction angle was 4 degrees, and because it's a left wind correction angle, we're going to subtract it. 45 minus 4 gives us a true heading of 41 degrees. Okay, and then we apply the magnetic variation. We looked on the chart and we found the isogonic line. It was 6 degrees to the west, and east is least, west is best, so we're going to add that 6 degrees. 41 true heading plus 6 variation gives us a magnetic heading of 047 degrees. Then we apply the deviation from the compass correction card, which was minus 4 degrees. 047 minus 4 gives us a compass heading of 043 degrees.